Virtual reality is quickly making its way into our lives. It could represent an enormous change in how people around the world play games, embrace education, watch movies, and really eventually live life. VR is taking off in a big way, and the nation's content developers are increasingly pairing up their game contents with VR technology. It's the topic of our IT and Science Front this week by our Kim Ji-yeon.
Virtual reality is considered by many as one of the most promising sectors in the so-called fourth industrial revolution. VR is expected to fundamentally change our daily lives, as its potential is evident in various sectors, ranging from education and entertainment to commerce. But challenges still remain for its broader application, such as the lack of content.
Local VR content developers are trying to change that by making people more familiar with VR technology through new releases in the gaming sector this year.
And here's where the loss makes its entrance. A newly developed VR game in which the user becomes a detective, trying to solve a murder case by deciphering clues, such as fingerprints and pieces of evidence gathered at a virtual crime scene. The game has already been distributed for beta testing among gamers in China and through the Google platform last year, and it's expected to be officially released by the end of the year.
One of the most outstanding points of The Lost compared to other games is that it features a unique gaming experience by enhancing spooky elements through VR technology, thus fully immersing users into the game's story.
The startup says the game can also be used as an educational tool to help students develop rational thinking skills and plans to broaden content for users to get familiar with VR technology. Another content developer is using a similar strategy through its virtual shooting game, The Mortal Blitz VR. The way the game is played is similar with other shooting games, but the huge difference is that the player is virtually transported inside the game itself.
We've been able to provide the game in almost all head-mounted devices currently in the market because more high-end VR devices are increasingly using similar operating systems and interface features.
The shooting game is being developed for users of various devices, including Samsung's Gear VR, which was launched late last year. For PlayStation VR set users, the game will be released worldwide on October 13th, while versions for the HTC Vive and Oculus Rift is to be laid out in the market by the end of the year. Both Skonek and Pocket Memory say they're working on the development of VR advertisement in the future that could customize the ads a user might be interested in by incorporating eye-tracking functions and big data technology. The startups say they hope to develop other forms of VR content, apart from popular games that could touch upon almost every aspect of our daily lives. Kim Ji-yeon, Arirang News.